I hope you are all good and safe. Last class you learned some problems from the exercise 3.5 based on three concepts: rational root theorem as well as reciprocal equations, and then one more thing, non-polynomial. Today also we are going to do the same exercise. Today we are going to continue the same exercise 3.5. Listen the class carefully. Look at your book. Problem number 4. Solve 2 root x by a plus 3 root a by x equal to b by a plus 6 a by b. Here we are going to solve the given equation. Solve 2 root x by a plus 3 root a by x equal to b by a plus 6 a by b. Now we are going to solve this equation. Here I am going to take root x by a as y. Here we can take this as the equation number 1. Now the equation 1 becomes 2, instead of this I am going to put y plus 3. Now look at this, here we are having root a by x which is reciprocal to this. So we can write root a by x as 1 by y equal to b by a plus 6a by b. There will be no change in the RHS. Now I am going to cross multiply y with 2y. So what will happen? So 2y square plus 3y equal to, here also I am going to do the same thing, cross multiplication. So b into b square plus 6a square by a into b ab. Now we can go for the cross multiply. Once again, 2y square plus 3 into ab equal to y into b square plus 6a square. Now 2y square ab plus 3ab equal to yb square plus 6a square y. Now I am going to bring these two terms into the left side. So the next step would be 2y square ab plus 3ab minus yb square minus 6a square y plus 3ab equal to 0. Now, from these two terms, I am going to take yb as the common factor. So, the remaining will be 2ya minus b. From these two, we can take minus 3a as the common factor. So, the remaining will be 2ya minus b equal to 0. Then our factors will be 2ya minus b into yb minus 3a equal to 0. Now our y will be 2ya equal to b, y equal to b by 2a. We got one value for y. Then from this, yb equal to 3a. Then y equal to 3a by b. Now I'm going to substitute the two y values in the assumption. Okay, what's our assumption? Root x by a equal to 1. Instead of y, I'm going to put b by 2e. So what will happen? So root x by a equal to y, instead of y, b by 2e. Look at the LHS. Here we're having root. So in order to delete root, what we have to do? We have to squaring on both sides. So I'm going to squaring on both sides. So the next step would be x by a equal to b square divided by 4a square. Then 1a will get cancelled. So our x equal to b square divided by 4a. We got a 1x value, that is b square divided by 4a. Then again I'm going to substitute y as 3a by b in our assumption. Root x by a equal to y. What's our y? 3a by b. Now I'm going to do the same thing, squaring on both sides. What will get? X by a equal to 9a squared over by b squared. Then our x will be 9a cubed by b squared. We got our required values. Then look at the third one. Solve. Third one, what's our given? 8x power 3 by 2n minus 8x power minus 3 by 2n equal to 63. Now we are going to solve this given equation. Here what I'm going to do? Here we can take the common term as y. Here our common term is 3 by 2n. So I'm going to take, let y equal to 3 by 2n. You can consider this as equation number 1. Then if we put y as 3 by 2n, then the equation 1 becomes a x power 3 by n is y minus 8 x power, here we can have x power y power minus 1 equal to 63. Now 8y minus 8 by y equal to 63. Now we can go for the cross multiply. So y 8 y square minus 8 divided by y equal to 63. Now I'm going to bring this y to the right side. So 8y square minus 8 equal to 63y. The next step would be 8y square minus 63y minus 8 equal to 0. Now we can solve this equation by splitting the middle term process. So here our multiplicative factor will be minus 64. Additive factor minus 63. So our required numbers are minus 64 plus 1. So what will happen? 8y square minus 64y plus y minus 8 equal to 0. Now from these two I am going to take 8y as the common factor. So 8y into y minus 8. Plus from this we can take 1 as a common factor, so 1 into y minus 8 equal to 0. Now y minus 8 into 8y plus 1 equal to 0. Now our y is 8, or 8y equal to minus 1, y equal to minus 1 by 8. Here we got 2y values. Now we are going to substitute these two values in our assumption.
So
what's our assumption? Y equal to 3 by 2a. Then this I'm going to put here. We should take y as x power 3 by 2a. So y equal to x power 3 by 2a. So I'm going to put y as 8 in this, so 8 equal to x power 3 by 2a. Then 8 can be written as 2 power 3 equal to x power 3 by 2a. Now I'm going to bring this power into the left side, so what will happen? 2 power 3 whole power 2n by 3. So these two will get cancelled equal to x. So 2 power 2n equal to x. This 2 power n can be written as 2 power 2 whole power n equal to x. 2 2's are 4. 4 power n equal to x. So we got our x as
4 power n.
Now I'm going to substitute y as minus 1 by 2 in our assumption. Now minus 1 by 8 equal to x power 3 by 2a. Now it can be written as minus 1 by 8 can be written as 2 power 3 equal to x power 3 by 2a. Now this can be written as minus 2 power minus 3 equal to x power 3 by 2a. The next step, minus 2 power whole power 3 2n by 3 equal to x. These two will get cancelled. So what's the remaining? Minus 2 power minus 2 power n equal to x. This now x equal to minus into 2 power minus 2n can be written as 1 by 2 power 2n. So this is equal to minus 1 by 2 to the 4 power n, which is not possible. So our x value is 4 power n. Then look at the next one.
Look at the second one. Examine
for the rational root of the given equation.
We are going to find the rational root for the given equation.
What's a given? 2x cube minus x square minus 1 equal to 0. Okay, now here we are going to find some of the coefficients. Sum of the coefficients equal to 2 minus 1 minus 1. Here 0. We got sum of the coefficients as 0. So we can conclude that x minus 1 is a factor. Since x minus 1 is the factor, so x equal to 1 is the root. So here our root is x equal to 1. We are going to find some other factor. We are going to find other factors by a synthetic division. I think you are all familiar with the synthetic division. I am going to do the synthetic division. 1. Here we are having 2 minus 1. Here we don't have any x term, so I am going to put 0. That is a constant minus 1. Now I am going to start with the 0. If you add these two, we will get 2. 1 into 2, 2. 1. 1 into 1, 1. 1. 1. We got our remainder as 0. So now I am going to write the other factor. So other factor equal to, what's the other factor? From this we can write the quadratic factor. So 2x square plus x plus 1. Here we can't solve this, we can't factorize this by us splitting the middle term concept. So we can go for formula, quadratic formula method. So we can solve this by a quadratic formula method. So here our a equal to 2, b equal to 1, c also 1. So now we will write the quadratic equation, quadratic formula, x equal to minus b plus or minus root b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Now we are going to substitute the values. So what was b? 1. So minus 1 plus or minus root b square. What? B square 1 minus 4 into a 2. So 4 into 2, 8 into 1, 8 divided by 2 into 2, 4. Now this is equal to minus 1 plus or minus root minus 7 divided by 4. This is minus 1 plus or minus. Here minus 7 can be written as 7 into minus 1. As we know, the minus 1 is the I square. So square root of I square is I root 7 divided by 4, which is a irrational root. But we need a rational root. So our required rational root is x equal to 1. Then look at the first one. Solve the following equation.
Or you can take alpha. alpha. Then our x will be x is 8. If we have sin x equal to sin alpha, then x will be 2n pi plus alpha. Thus, compare these two. Instead of sin alpha, here we are having pi by 2. Here we are having pi by 2 as the alpha. So our x will be x equal to 2n pi plus alpha. Instead of alpha, I am going to put pi by 2 is the required value. Similarly, you can do the second one as the home. You can find the first factor for the given equation by a trial and error method. First, you can take the given equation as p of x, and then you can find p of 1, p of minus 1, and then you can find p of 2. If p of 2 equals 0, we can conclude x minus 2 is the factor. After that, you can find other factor by using the synthetic division. After that, as usual, you can complete the problem. Okay. Thank you.